Hello everyone and welcome to Scandinavian Design 101. Today I'm going to show you some more books about Scandinavian design. We did a video like this a couple of weeks ago and some of you wanted to see if we have any more books to show you, and we do. I will start with, last time we showed you mainly very expensive books, and they were very nice, but everyone perhaps don't want to buy a book for like $50 or $80. So this is a bit cheaper books mainly. And the first book is about Alvar Aalto. It's called Aalto. Yeah, simple and easy to remember. The publisher is Taschen. And it's good to remember because Taschen has a lot of good design books for a cheap price. And this one is about $10, so it's a cheap book. And it's not a big book, but it's still worth buying, at least for that small amount of money. And in the book, you will get a lot of different examples of his interiors, mainly his interiors, not that much about the furniture, but it's a lot of beautiful pictures of his many modernist buildings and a brief history of his life. It's called Aalto, and it's a good start if you want to learn more about Aalto. Now let's see. I think we can continue because this book is in English, and we will take another book in English too here, and we have this one, and it's a beautiful little book. It's actually about a Finnish textile artist called Maija Isola, and perhaps you heard about her. She's done a lot of different textile patterns, mainly for Marimekko, and they are very, very beautiful. It's a lot of pictures here with different patterns and the names of them. It's just one problem with this book, I would say, and that's you want to buy all the textiles when you see them, and most of them are almost impossible to come by today, so that's the sad part of it. But I really like this book. And the problem with this one is, we bought this in a bookstore, but now when I tried to look it up, I couldn't find it. So perhaps this one is out of print, but I think you can find it on Amazon or somewhere on the a secondhand bookstore. It should be possible to come by. And it's a good book if you want to learn more about her exciting life too. She's a very interesting woman. And then we have one more book in English, and it's a book about not really a Scandinavian designer. It's the book about Eero Saarinen. It's called Minimum Design, but he's still almost a Scandinavian designer because his father, Eliel Saarinen, was from Finland. So, but of course, Eero Saarinen did most of his works in the US. And you've all seen his beautiful furniture, like the tulip chair and the warm chair. That's a favorite. And this is a quite big book. And it's the focus is on his buildings and interiors. A lot of nice interiors by Saarinen, but also, of course, the different furniture. This is a book still available in the bookstore. It's a bit more expensive. I don't really remember, but I guess it was like $30 or something. But it's really worth buying if you like modern design. And then it's, of course, a problem with books about Scandinavian design. And the big problem is that most books are written in Swedish or Danish. And if you don't understand any of the Scandinavian languages, that you can't really understand what's in them. But there are some exceptions, and I think this book, it's called Norske Stoler, it means Norwegian chairs. And it's written in Norwegian, But it's still a good book if you like it's Scandinavian design, because it's a reference book too. You can't read all the text, but you can look at the pictures and you can read the byline. And there you can know the name of the furniture and who made it and when they were made and so on. So even if you don't understand Norwegian, buy this book, because it's a good reference book. And of course, it's also a good start if you want to learn Scandinavian languages like Norwegian or Swedish. This one is written by Svein Gusrud and Mats Linder, and they are like the kings when it comes to Norwegian furniture history. And then, at last, I want to show you some books, very cheap Swedish books, soft, what do you call them in Sweden? We call them pocket books, but I think you call them soft cover, no? Small books, at least, about Scandinavian design. They are, the publisher is called Rosti Back. And this small publisher doesn't exist any longer, but most of the books can still be found in a bookstore. And they are extremely cheap. They are like $5 each. So they are, I mean, if you find them, just buy them before they are no longer. And here are four examples that we really like. And for example, we have the books about Josef Frank and Estrid Eriksson. Estrid Eriksson, the founder of firma Svenskt Tenn, and Josef Frank, who really did amazing furniture and lamps for Svenskt Tenn. And they are written in Swedish. As you can see, a lot of text in the beginning, but then it's a big part of the book that's just a lot of photographs. And it's also a good reference book, because as with the other book, you can read the name and the date and so on each object. So even if you don't understand the language, you can just pay like $5 and you get a great reference book. And also about a book about Bruno Mattsson, and the one about Axel Einar Hjort. Also, good reference books. Yeah. And this was some examples of books about Scandinavian design. If you want to have any other examples and so on, just make a comment here, and we can try to see if we can find any books about Scandinavian design in English. And thanks a lot for watching. If you like this video, please click thumbs up and subscribe. And of course, follow us on Instagram. We are called Scandinavian Design 101. Thanks a lot.